You wonder what a defense is built upon, because it can't really be the experiences. So what is it? Is it the air force that just states something, or is it the person becomes a secret police when the air force is related to the defense of the country, because there are so many experiences that we wish to keep as more of a diplomatic kind. For example, you say we defend ourselves by a model that looks like the defense. It's this model where the person is placed besides an object. Probably is the description of the war rather than probably in this case an indication of another country's air force. Hence we use it as a defense model, which makes the history more apparent, not something to falsify, which is crucial in physics, for example, where you have this Air Force model. It's built upon how you actually defend and that's you know, individual only, so it's a professional military, and that's the only difference, more or less. So for example, when you have air force, it's very crucial that the individual gets the right value, and this is humanistic question. Should we go to war, more or less? Whereby the press starts, the president gets to be the chief general. It's where we use the regional stuff more or less, like where the air defense, so it's like the air force within the war, more or less. And when it comes to how we actually defense, is probably a better way of doing it. In other words, use a model rather than rely on empiricism, which only probably creates the doctoral interest, more or less. So when the academics is in war, you will notice it for sure, because it's the doctoral interest of empiricism that fails, you know, as this or that, because the essence lies in something else, which I have experienced, probably described as a naval battle. The other person looks besides him, and thus you know, when the marine battle starts, how you defend, this is an academic question. You place out the Air Force, one object within a system, creates the action. It's like physics is it moves fast, you know, goes long. It's like spores or something. The ethnical individuals start to move in the system. It's you know, like a comedy. It's like very funny, but it's to the Air Force within the war. The ethnical individual goes long, and it's, you know, as funny, you know. So you see, the press says that the consulate in London of Sweden looks like a police station. And this could be, you know, the panzer wagons just forcing in over the border to the next country. Should we view that as an air attack? You know, should we view that as when the marine, you know, just tragically clears their anti-Zionists, because Das Boot, you know, really exists as an object. I mean, Mossad would view that as the nuclear, you know, affair of French as well as British, Chilean interests, Colombian interests. You know, etc. Is that the case for, you know, the experts that uses only ethnicity for the description of a war? For example, you say, they do this every time with this Condoleezza Rice. Is it Bush? Or is it, you know, when the defense becomes something else, like expertise on Yugoslavia and Kuwait or the... I just totally lose everything they, you know, invest. Because, you know, marine defense didn't hold. It's like, we have rented an Air Force specialist for the Air Force of the other country to defend defend. Isn't he, you know, like the NATO specialist? No, it's a marine guy. As you know, Metallica and Burning Heart in this Rocky movie goes long on the side of the two moment, the two sides of the road. This, you know, didn't mix everything up. Is it that, is that a nuclear weapon? Is that the model of a nuclear weapon? Or should they use this general for one, fault? You know, in history. I mean, if they really want to be anti-Zionists, you know, go ahead. You know, I was a bit surprised myself. You know, the embassy in, or the consulate in London, from Sweden, it looks like the police station. And boom, you know, we're dead in anyway, probably, because, you know, bombings in London in Second World War.